A new federal standard and the city's first ever sewer system are just two of the lasting results of the Great Fire of Baltimore. That fire started 110 years ago today and is an important part of the city's history. 11 News reporter Jennifer Franciotti takes a look back.
All these streets were destroyed.
At the Fire Museum of Maryland, one of the most popular exhibits reveals the history of the Great Fire of Baltimore. It happened 110 years ago this weekend. 140 acres were destroyed in less than 2 days in a fire that stretched a mile across the city.
86 blocks burned in 30 hours. Blocks were falling at the rate of one every 20 minutes. Another block would fall.
The fire started Sunday morning, February 7th, inside the Hearst building on Liberty Street.
We believe that a cigarette had fallen down into the basement and smoldered there.
The dry goods store exploded, and by the time it was all said and done, the fire would destroy 1,500 buildings and 2,500 businesses in its path to the Jones Falls, where firefighters would stop the flames before ravaging the entire city. Amazingly, only two people lost their lives.
However, the worst tragedy was, just like the 9/11 survivors, a lot of these firemen died of pneumonias and smoke inhalation and lung disease.
Fire companies came by train from Philly, D.C., New York, and Delaware to help, but their hose couplers didn't fit Baltimore hydrants. It's a problem that would lead to federal hydrant standards just 2 years later. And resilient, it took only 2 years to rebuild the city. Its layout, though, would be forever changed.
One of the reasons why the fire was so devastating is because the streets had been laid out since colonial times. They were narrow. The firemen would get up into a section, and the flames would leap over them and just keep spreading. They couldn't get out in time. They widened the streets. They buried all the electric lines that actually blocked the water from getting onto the buildings. And they started the first sewer system in Baltimore. They didn't have sewer systems before that.
At the Lutherville Fire Museum, you can see hundreds of old pictures, artifacts, and actual fire apparatus from the third worst fire in the nation's history.
And if you want to learn more about the Great Fire of Baltimore, the museum has put out four books like this on the subject. And there's also a tour on Sunday that starts right here at the museum and ends in the burnt district. Here in Lutherville, Jennifer Franciotti, WBAL-TV 11 News.